Welcome to episode 6 of Business Nuggets by Martwayne, a series of short tips and tricks that will kickstart or help you in your business as well as on your entrepreneurship journey. My name is Tope Williams Adeomi. I'm an entrepreneur, a trainer, a fashion professional, and business consultant. I run Martwayne, where we help you turn your passion to profit. And today we'll be talking about why and how you should delegate your work to avoid breaking down. This is a response to a question I received in my inbox from someone who bought my ebook, How to Start a Clothing Factory. She asked, "Please, I find it very difficult delegating duties, thereby stressing so hard. Please, how do I go about it? How do I accept that another person can do it well? I want to take steps to employ workers. Can you offer advice to me, please?" Right. So many of us have faced it and some are currently facing it. I used to be there before, so I know exactly how this feels. I remember how it used to be for me then. I wrote about this in my ebook, 7 Mistakes Not to Make as an Entrepreneur. You can get it as a free download on the Martwayne website. I thought I was Wonder Woman until I broke down and was on mandatory bed rest for 2 weeks. I was literally throwing up from stress. I also remember a post I wrote on my blog a few years ago. It was about a lady who was meant to attend my wedding then. She had even bought the fabric, but she didn't show up. When I asked her what happened, she gave me some shocking news. She told me how she had a stroke as a result of stress. A young mother in her early 30s had a stroke and had to learn to walk again. And her story gave rise to the blog post, Voluntary Rest or Mandatory Bed Rest? Choose one. Now, I'm sure many of you out there are experiencing the horrors of stress. Not only is life expectancy reducing, you don't even deliver great work when you are stressed. A question you should ask yourself is, what is the point of working so hard if you end up spending all that money on medication? You should make money to live a better life, not try to fix the new life you have that was not initially broken. We have all heard that health is wealth. If only you knew the havoc stress and lack of sleep causes on the body. Now, I know we feel we are the best and we are the only ones that can do it the perfect way. But here is a huge shocker for you. Not only are there people that can do it better than you can, you will also not have a life. I told myself a long time ago that I did not want to run a business that needed me to be on ground before it functioned. And because I made that decision, I started putting structures in place to make that work. It took a long time, but I worked towards it. You also need to determine what you want for your business and structure your business around what is convenient for you and not the other way around. The minute you make that decision, your mind will begin to work on how to try and achieve that. So to answer the question of how can I delegate, the first thing you need to realize is that you cannot do the work yourself if you want your business to grow. A friend of mine once said, the more operational you are, the poorer you become. And this is so true. If you are so operational in nature, you will never have the time to work on growing the business or even networking. So if you think you are the only person who can make your business work, then you have it all wrong. If you want your business to work, you need to put structures in place. And how do you do that? One easy way is by employing people either as full-time or contract staff. You should be the one supervising, not doing the work yourself. And by supervising, I don't mean micromanaging people. That alone gives you even more stress. Put people in charge of these duties and trust that they will do the work. Like I said in episode 1, what is the worst that could happen? To answer the question of how can you delegate and trust that people will do the work? The first thing I would say is you have to train them. I know the fear is if I train them, then they will leave. Well, if you don't train them, they will either wreck your work or you could end up doing the work you are paying them to do. Why are you employing people and paying them if you end up doing all the work yourself? I wrote about a strategy you can adopt to make people stay with you for a little while longer. It works for me. So if you get the ebook on how to start a clothing factory, you can try it out and see if it will work for you. And rid yourself of the fear that people will leave. People always do. No one is indispensable and no one should be indispensable. Not even you. Look at all the designers who have died and even Steve Jobs, God rest their souls. Their companies still live on. So train people and trust them to do the work. If you cannot afford to employ people, then outsource the work to a competent company. In fact, that might even be better. That way, the core of your work is not on you and you can focus on running the business. Can you afford to? Yes, you can. All you need to do is simply bill the customer for it at the end of the day or spread the costs. Quit trying to save money and losing more in the long run. The opportunity cost is the real cost and the real cost is the time spent, and you know time is money. The third thing I will say is give people responsibilities. Ask their opinion and adopt their ideas. Even if you feel it won't work, and you might even lose money in the process, that employee is happy that their idea was adopted and feels valued. That way, they begin to take ownership of their work. I'm not saying you should play Russian roulette with customers' orders. No, that's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is you can choose to test their level of competencies when the pressure is not on. I learn from my staff all the time. In fact, I can't micromanage. If you keep asking me questions, I start getting agitated because really, why are you there? You are there to make life easier for me, not add more stress to my life. The how to delegate is answered by giving larger responsibilities. And if you want to be as bold as I was, breaking up the process and staying away from the office so you force people to actually make things work in your absence. Ask your staff questions. Adopt their methods. In fact, one thing I do is tell them to try their methods and then try my method and we vote on which one is better. If theirs is better, I have no issues with accepting that it is better and I tell them to go along with it. It means they can't do it without me. There are things I also close my eyes to. As long as it doesn't affect the quality of our product or service and it is not a deal breaker, then I just look the other way. For example, I tell them to create procedural manuals in production, which is part of our process. Sometimes when they don't do it, I don't stress out about it. As long as they get the job done, in the time it should be done, I won't lose any sleep over it. So, dear business owner, never operate a business under the premise that you know it all and that it has to be your way or the highway. You will give yourself BP issues and set yourself up. What is more important is delivering outstanding service at the lowest cost to the customer. The how does not really matter. Like they say, there are so many ways to skin a cat. What is more important is achieving the goal than stressing over the small stuff. Don't get me wrong, it does take time, but start today, start to make an effort, and eventually you will begin to free yourself from operations. Okay then, to the lady who asked me this question, I hope this helps. I'm certain that you will get more answers in the ebook you bought. To others listening, I hope this also helped you. If it did, do leave a comment and tag others who need this as well or who are facing these issues. Yes, and if you also have questions, you can leave them in the comment section or chat me inbox and I will try to address them in future podcasts that I create. Don't forget to hit the notification bell above my handle so you know when next I drop a podcast. Thank you so much. My name is Tope Williams Adeomi and you have just listened to episode 6 of Business Nuggets by Martwayne. Have an excellent day. Cheers.